Well, we've been away making a new record. And that record comes out at midnight tonight. But you guys, only you guys, are going to preview this record for everybody else.
Is brand new today, so this week we just started trying to make a live version of that. So it's quite fun. So like, the record's been finished now for quite some time, so to finally have it out, like released into the wild. Don't hesitate. It's like a pop song in our way. We tried to make a pop song, but it still came out kind of bad skulls. I guess when we finished the record, Emma would say it was like a melancholy disco, you know, like a sad disco song. Yeah. But when we're playing it live, it will evolve now, like all the songs will, and find their like home. That they always just change a little bit, right? Most different record you've ever made, and then of course you then take those songs onto the road with your other material, and they all seem to kind of glue together somehow, even if you try and completely do everything opposite to you've ever done before. When we made our first record, our producer Ian gave us a really good bit of advice, which I think is good for other young bands, is like, don't put all of your tricks onto your first song or your first record. Just do like one side of yourself, and then you can almost evolve, but like with your ideas. Like we wanted to put all the ideas we had on our very first record on Baby Darling, and Ian was really strict with us and was like, you know, put that away, no. Which I at the time was kind of frustrated with him. I was like, come on, let's go for it. Put the synths on, block and spiel. The rest of it, but it was cool because we got to reveal the elements of our band every record as we went. And of course, by then you really know yourself a bit more, and essentially you probably do a better job than you would have done struggling with it on the first record.
Another song we wrote here in Southampton. You see, this is a good place to write songs. This song is from my first record. If you could sing it with us in this beautiful building, that would be really great.
Never started a tour in Southampton before. I mean, you know, you normally go to Heathrow and leave. It's you know, touring normally for us is leaving, and we play here, you know, every couple of years, and so often at the end. So to start the new era for the band and start our touring life here at home is really special.
Yeah, it feels good to begin the new momentum.
Younger, we both grew up here. When we were younger, we would do that. Like, it was more of a, like a fantasy. Like, oh, look at that amazing ice
one
go around the
might
town.
Be able to play there.
Yeah, not like the very cool venues, because we have the Joiners, which is just here, which is the more famous rock club. It's really small. It's like less than 200. But that's been going since the 60s and all through the 90s. And when we were going to see bands for the first time, just around the corner, everyone played there. Oasis, Radiohead, Coldplay. and then right through to Libertines and all the bands. It's like one of those first touring routes around the country. If you come to the city, that's where you would play. Find this venue. Has anyone been here before? No one. Sorry about that. Well, I hope you like it.
Yeah, we walked around town. We were trying to find somewhere different and new, and just to kind of have a change, really, and make it a bit more exciting for us and also the audience. It's kind of quite exciting knowing that there's quite a lot of people going to come tonight who have never been inside this building before, even though. They live in Southampton, they've lived here their whole lives, so it's quite nice to kind of open that up for people.
Southampton used to be a bit, it felt like a bit more competitive, but now it's definitely a sense of everyone's together and a supportive network of people, and especially in the, it's a small enough city, I said this to you last night, it's a big city, but the music seems small enough that you know everyone. Never got the way it goes and you walk through the door. It was always a haze, something new to pass the haze. I was all blinkered and blind, and you blew my mind.
Just so good, so good for me now. You're so good.
We all just came together. I mean, it was not just our hard work, but all of our team and our new label, and it just all, it's all come together with regrouping the band. You know, there's been lots of changes in the last couple of years. We've had so much support for what we've been trying to do on this next kind of stage of what we've done as well. So lots of the audience have pre-ordered the album on the whole tour. So basically, if they were here tonight, you're kind of supporting the band, and we really appreciate that. So it's going to be to give them something back, for them all giving us all of that reassurance that we're doing the right thing.
And this one goes out to all of you, all of our friends and our family that are here. It's all for you guys. Thank you very much. Jumping on the lip.